Okay, our footer's built out. Now let's make it responsive. Let's make our way over to tablet mode. Now, first things first, we might not have the greatest visibility here with a darker color on a darker color. We can change, of course, to something else for increased visibility. Everything looks good outside of the grid, and in the grid, we can make other adjustments. For instance, we can add some extra rows. Same technique we used before, we can drag our content straight into each additional row, into the first column. So now that we have a 1x3, we can successfully remove the other two columns. Just delete our second and third columns. And that's it. We can make other tweaks. There's some other stuff going on here. For instance, the logo, we can adjust its alignment. And a creative way to do that with grid is just select the parent grid and set the children alignment, in terms of horizontal, to center. The logo and buttons went to the center. Let's test responsiveness on each breakpoint. Tablet looks pretty good. Let's go to mobile landscape, and we can test responsiveness there as well, just looking to see everything reflows. And we can test mobile portrait. Now, since each of the app buttons is a child of the wrapper, we could select the wrapper and override its grid child settings. Just set that to stretch so it's full width. Everything stretches to the edge, and we know that the wrapper that contains the buttons, its parent is the grid and its parent is the container. So we'll simply apply the container class to the container. Just type in the first few letters, there's container, and that's it. The padding looks good in mobile portrait, mobile landscape, tablet looks good, desktop looks great. And that's making a responsive footer in grid. In the next part of our course, we'll take a quick look at keyboard navigation and accessibility in preparation for publishing the completed project.